This is pretty serious, as you can see. It is from this virus and has caused my face to have paralysis.
Justin Bieber taking to social media this weekend, telling his fans the reason why he's canceling his shows. It's a relatively unknown facial condition. It's called Ramsey-Hunt syndrome.
The rare neurological disorder causes partial paralysis in the face, but there are other serious symptoms that people can suffer from as well. And joining us now to talk more about this is Rush University Medical Center Dr. Peter Revenaugh, who is the head of their facial nerve disorder and rehab program. Thank you so much for coming on the show this morning.
Thank you very much for having me, Sean and Gaynor.
So let's start here. Tell us more about some of the symptoms of this syndrome and what causes it.
Yeah, some of the symptoms can be pain around the ear, facial paralysis, of course, hearing loss, and an eruption of vesicles in front of the ear.
So what we know right now, this, if you've had chickenpox in the past, we've heard of the shingles vaccine that we can get, and this is kind of an offshoot of shingles. It just happens to be where the virus pops up, and it's right in the nerve by the ear, correct?
That's correct. Luckily, it's very rare, affecting only 5 out of 100,000 people a year, but obviously very concerning when it happens.
So can it be a permanent condition? What is the standard treatment?
So the standard treatment is early intervention, typically with high-dose steroids and antivirals as soon as you know what the diagnosis is. The long-term prognosis is generally good. There are some people that have even long-term effects from it, but unfortunately, time will tell.
It is a matter of time from diagnosis to treatment that I understand is what causes the permanent scarring or nerve damage. Is this possible? It looks like Justin has caught this in time, where his hearing and his ability to use his face and mouth may be restored to full capacity.
Yeah, there are some very encouraging signs in the video that Justin posted. One is that he has only partial paralysis. We can see some evidence of movement in his forehead and some other areas. And then he also has some muscle tone of the face. So that indicates it wasn't a complete paralysis. And those patients that don't have complete paralysis often go on to have good recovery.
So what is the emotional toll that this takes on patients when you think about not even, you know, being able to smile, function in your normal way?
The emotional toll is incredible. I mean, this gives an opportunity to shed some light on facial paralysis in general, Bell's palsy, and other conditions that affect patients. It can be very difficult. Not only, as Justin said, he has difficulty closing his eye and moving the corner of his mouth, but it affects your ability to express emotion, interact with other people, and many people become very upset by the inability to talk easily and smile to others.
Now, it is rare, obviously. You said 5 in 100,000 patients. When we're talking about that small of a population, is this something you can prevent, though, with maybe a shingles vaccine?
Yes. So shingles and chickenpox vaccines can be effective in preventing this. And so obviously those are encouraged for those populations.
All right, Dr. Peter Revenaugh with Rush University Medical Center. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thanks so much for having me.